Hi, my name is Moses Obibi, and today I'm going to do a quick unboxing and review for you on a new Mr. H scooter bus. At the moment, we've got some quite deadly packaging, as I would say. It's pretty thick, pretty hardcore. We'll obviously hold the bars strengthening. As you can see, these are quite long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and open them, and then I'm going to run through some of the specs with you. All right. Had to replace the last tool, as you can see. Proving harder than I expected. I'm not gonna lie to you. Should have got probably a slightly sharper knife. Okay, so we're almost there. So yeah, I've got some stickers and some other little thing. I think it's a key ring of like what one of Mr. H Pegs is, but I'm not 100% sure, but that's what it looks like. But that's the sticker and that's Peg. I'll go through those in a minute, actually. So let's get that open. So yeah, one sticker. This is Mr. H Scooter Bars, as you can see, with a female decal. And this, which I'm guessing is a Mr. H Peg, but obviously just a key ring. Or you could probably put it on like a mini MGP scooter, cool thing. Let's just say it's a key ring, it's pretty cool anyway. So, as we go on. Alright, okay, probably put the lethal weapon down now. Okay, alright, so as you can see, these are the new Mr. H T bars. First, I'll start off with dimensions. Okay, so these are made specifically for me. So we've got them 24 wide and by 35 high, a standard size tube I've got here. No slip for SCS compression, so that's obviously if you want to raise up the compression a little bit more, but it's quite high as they are already, so if you wanted to cut a bit off you probably could. So yeah, like I said, 24 wide, 35 high, inches wise. The really good thing about these bars is that they've got extra strong welding. I'm not sure if you can see those there, but just around the front, it's exactly the same on the opposite side, and it cups underneath. Just where the bars would usually bend, we've got an extra bit of welding there that completely strengthen it a lot more than most T-bars usually do, so you're not sort of looking to get any sort of cracks or bends around this area at all, which is where they usually would get cracked. 35 high is probably the limit that you could get bars the tallest without them sort of snapping or anything. I don't know if anybody's ever made any bars any taller than this, but this is what you'd be looking at. Matte black in colour, also come powder coated. And before they get sent out to you, they're beautifully sort of brilliant, they look perfect. They're really nice weight, I would say. They're not too heavy for steel bars. My steel bars you get these days are quite heavy, just to match up the weight and sort of the rest of the skillet, but these aren't too heavy as well for the steel bars actually, to be fair, so I think they'll go on really, really well. But other than that, these are really good. But yeah, those are the dimensions, the Mr. H again. And yeah, drop some comments below. Any questions that you want answered, I'll give you an answer. Hopefully I can get some tips on these later on. Thanks.